I am a head and neck cancer surgeon, and cancer surgery and treating cancer patients has occupied most of my professional life for the last 20 odd years. As we look back upon our journey till now, of course, coming into work is still as exciting as the first day, simply because of the reason that the patients who have been waiting for you and who expect you to give you standard of care treatment are the ones which cannot be ignored day in and day out. My work as a cancer surgeon has involved pretty much a 365-day routine in which, even if we are not really available on some days, we have to be virtually available in this new post-COVID world, and that's relevant every single day of our working lives. I believe that hospital-acquired infections and the management thereof has undergone a sea change. Not only have diagnostic modalities, not just culture techniques, but also other technologies have helped us really predict what infection we are anticipating in a patient. And a combination of these clinical and microbiological findings has helped us detect more hospital-acquired infections. The problem, especially in our subcontinent, is the rise of resistant infections. And that has been due to the lack of something called antibiotic stewardship. That is an initiative that all hospitals of our size or even smaller or larger should be initiating. The hospital should have a very active infection control program. We are fortunate enough to be one of the hospitals that has it. And of course, we can't ignore technologies and the role of technologies in the same, which we'll probably talk about as part of your further discussion. As we have progressed over the last decade or so at our hospital in tackling resistant infections, it's important to adopt technology in confronting them as well. Therein the role of technology comes in terms of not just routine hand hygiene practices, but also in terms of having compliances, having our audits being done on a regular basis. To me, that is a very basic and sensible application of current day management protocols. Also, emerging technologies like plasma sterilization, like low temperature sterilization and other sterilization and disinfection techniques have played a role as we move along. I would encourage my peers to make sure that you adopt some kind of consolidated infection control program in your respective hospitals. And that, of course, will entail the implementation of a spectrum which starts at basic hand hygiene and goes all the way up to something more state-of-the-art like plasma sterilization. My advice to the ASP division, again, without any relevant financial relationships, it's a company which I believe has been at the forefront of technology for infection control. I would advise you guys to continue innovating, to continue bringing new technologies into the world. I've spent a number of my years in the West, and gladdens me to see that most technologies that are currently available in the West are not only available in India, but they are available almost immediately in India as soon as their global launch takes place. In fact, some infection control technologies owe their origin to our Indian subcontinent because we have such a large population base and thereby a large patient base as well. So I would just advise you to invest more in your R&D, improve your existing products as you have been, and make sure that we make the world together a better and a more infection-free place. Thank you.